If we were baptized as a baby, then our parents publicly proclaimed for us. And that when we get to the time of confirmation, or many of you have had confirmation, that is your time to publicly proclaim your faith in Jesus in front of the congregation and to make that commitment. And our confirmants will have to make that same commitment to Christ and His church when we're having confirmation Sunday. Then they will walk in the light. They will have made that choice as a young person for Jesus. And Nicodemus did not commit to Christ on that dark and late fateful night. He still had to wrestle with the deep, mind-blowing, spirit-raising words and revelations. So Jesus calls us to walk in the light in order to be saved and sanctified. And the Lord told old Nicodemus that unless one is born again or born from above, he or she cannot see the kingdom of God. And we know that the correct translation is born from above. But Nicodemus could not understand that. He got caught up in the idea of being reborn or born again. He did not understand the spiritual reality of what Jesus was talking about. He used many different metaphors to try and help him get it. He talked about walking in the light. He talked about earthly versus heavenly things. He spoke about darkness and destruction versus new life and eternal life. Jesus knew that Nicodemus was seeking spiritually, but he also knew that he didn't get it. Now, this is a common theme throughout the Gospels, that people constantly misunderstand what Jesus was trying to teach them. And sometimes we, too, struggle to get it. And they didn't get it. Christ was trying to explain to him a new life, living a spiritual life that comes from seeking Him. It also comes by seeking the Holy Spirit to guide our spiritual lives in Christ, not just once, but throughout our Christian lives. That although people can have that come to Jesus moment and surrender to God's love and grace, they can have that moment where they are somewhat born again. They can commit a confirmation time or later in life if they're an adult at any age. But that being born from above is the reality of constantly seeking Jesus and constantly asking the Holy Spirit to guide us along every step of the way. So we can and do come to Jesus again and again. We can be renewed spiritually and many times again and again. So these explanations were not working for Nicodemus. Therefore, the Lord reminded him of an old story that he would have known very well. As a Pharisee dedicated to the Torah and the teachings of Moses, he would have known deeply the story of the snakes biting and killing some of the Jews who complained and complained. Like I said before, they had OCD, obsessive complaining disorder. You may have met some of these people. Maybe at one time you were like that. I know there were times I did a lot of complaining until the Lord showed me the light. So they were complaining about God, about Moses, and wandering in the desert. That story was about one period of time in their walk with the Lord. So God told Moses to take a serpent, a bronze snake, put it on a pole and raise it up, and they were to look at it and be healed. But it only happened one time. In a way, they had been healed and saved that day. But Jesus was drawing this cultural bridge from the Old Testament story to what he was about to do. The Lord would say many, many, many times, "You have heard it said that Moses said unto you, but I say unto you." And then also, he's like saying, you know, Moses did this and that, but I'm going to do this and that. That he was greater than Moses. And that they didn't get that. They were insulted. How could you be greater than Moses?